In Ephesians chapter 4, they talk about the pastors, the preachers, the apostles, prophets, not just to do our ministry, but to equip saints. To equip saints for the ministry, for the building of the ministry. So as pastors, we don't just do everything ourselves. As pastors, we train people, we lead, build up people so that they can serve God. So when I have people that are willing to follow me, you know, I teach them, I guide them, I bring them to Jesus, or train them, or they're willing to be trained, what do I look for? I look for people who want to bless other people, who wants to serve God, who wants to give their life to God. The most important thing is their life quality. It's not their spiritual gifts. Whenever any person, they do anything, like they share, and then I find that they do very well. And then I will tell them, you have the gift of sharing. Or some people experience the Holy Spirit very easily. I tell them, you have the gift of experiencing the Holy Spirit, and you can also pray for other people, that your life can be built up. So I look for qualities in people. And the most important quality is the life quality of loving God and respecting God, honoring God, and the quality of being humble. So when I see people like that, I will give them opportunities. I will talk with them, I will listen to them, see what qualities I have. It's very important for us to realize that the time spent with people who want to serve God will have more result than when we minister to people who are always needy. Now, I minister to people who are needy all the time. People call me up all the time because I have videos online. Many people call me up. They didn't know me. They just call me up, Pastor, please pray for me. Pray for my sickness. Pray for my deliverance. I do that all the time. Even when we visit sick people, dying people, I mean, I should ask them to ask the pastor to do it. They might have asked the pastor to do it, but they still like someone else to do it. I will spend time to go there and pray for the sick people. Why do I do that? Because I care about people. But the most important thing in me is not to help the needy people. If I spend the time helping the needy people, I can be busy all day long helping the needy people, and they always have needs. So when I pray for someone who I need, I always tell them, God has blessed you. Isn't that wonderful? And they say, yes, it's wonderful. And I say, you can start to pray for other people. You can start to bless other people. So whenever I pray for someone, I tell them, you can start to bless other people. Don't just stop there. If you just want to get blessings, you will never grow strong. So I encourage people who I help. But I find that, very sadly, most of these needy people stay being needy all the time. I don't know if you have noticed that. Some people, they just say, oh, I have this problem, I have that problem, I have family problem, health problem, emotional problem. They continue to have problems because of the life qualities in them. Now, I'm not saying God cannot use them. God can use them. God uses weak people. But some soil is not good soil. It's not open to the work of God. They just want something for themselves. Now we help them, but we know that this is not the center of our ministry. The center of our ministry is on people who have a heart for God, who start to forget about themselves, who is willing to bless other people, even though they might be weak. But they say, I'm willing to bless other people, I'm willing to help people. Then I will pay attention to that person. And I will train them, I will listen to them, and then I will ask them what they do. And then I will ask them to send me them. I train them to preach, I train them to lead worship, I train them to do counseling, I train them to do different things, and they send it to me by WhatsApp or email. And I will listen to them and respond to them. Because these people have potential.
Amen.
That's the first step. I know these people who have potential, who are willing to serve God. And then I will help them to handle the problems in their life. But the next step, how can I help them to go further? Not just that stage, to go further. Now the first thing is, for anyone who wants to serve God, who wants to bless other people, is to do the ministry around them. Now some people say, I've heard people say, one day I want to lead 1,000 people meeting. I want to lead 10,000 people meeting. When I hear that, I'm not impressed. Because they just look for a number. But when I see people, they always care about the people around them. They will preach the gospel to them, help them, pray for them. But these are the people that I see that is very precious because they want to bless people. The people who just want 10,000 people meeting, they want something great for themselves. Amen. They want their name to be exalted. Amen. I think a lot of times there could be pride in it. We don't want pride because for me, why do I have the motivation to take care of problems? As I said this morning, it's like this. When we serve, we are building on the foundation of Jesus Christ. When we build on the foundation, very often when we have pride, or hurt, or anger, or frustration, or negative thinking, then we are tearing it down. We're building and tearing it down. Then some people, when they serve God, they put in a lot of effort, but only 1% of the effort is remembered by God. Isn't that sad? And even some people give offering to the Lord. They give a lot of money. Maybe $100. A lot of money. $200, $500, $1,000. But they give with a heart to let people know, I give so much. Then maybe in God's eyes, it's only $1. Because this pride takes away all the, you know, the good things in his work when he offers. God only remembers him like he remembers someone who gives $1 because he has the heart to get attention from other people. I've seen one person, I don't know his attitude. Maybe he does nothing wrong. But I noticed that one time in a church that was serving, one woman, she gave a check to the pastor and said, this is my offering. I know this is a rich woman. Now she could have put the offering into the offering bag. Why did she give it to the pastor personally? Now, there might be other reasons, I don't know. There might be other reasons. Maybe she was giving to a special ministry. But maybe she was giving to the pastor to let the pastor know how much I give. If she does that, all she did could be just worth $1. So that's a waste of money. When we give so much money, we want to be remembered by God. When we serve God, we want to be remembered by God. So for people who have pride, who have personal problems, they're wasting their effort. So we examine our lives and say, yes, Lord, I want my offering, my ministry to be from a pure heart, from a humble heart. I'm nobody. We need to learn to say that. Can we say it together? I'm nobody. God chose me when I was weak.
God chose me when I was weak.
God used me when I was weak.
God used me when I was weak.
And He raised me up.
And He raised me up.
And He used me mightily.
Used me mightily.
All glory be to God.
All glory to God.
You know, I wholeheartedly believe that. But that's something I've handled many times. Let me tell you. When I pray for people, sometimes we experience the Holy Spirit very strong, very powerful. Many times it came to my mind, you are doing a good job. And then God spoke to me, who is it that worked on a person? Is it you or me? Immediately I became the Lord Jesus. It's your word. I'm nothing. And I find that this thought will come from time to time. And I keep telling myself, be humble. Don't waste your effort. If not, our effort will be wasted. God only remembers 1% or less of our ministry. So it's very important to look for people like that and build up people like that. And let people see the most important thing is the humility and a heart to glorify God and a heart to bless people, to have a heart of blessing people. That's very important. Let me share with you. When I go to different places to minister, in my heart, I don't think of the reward I will get. I always think of the need, people who needs the work of the Holy Spirit. When I see people, I always see, he has potential. He can do great things. What can I do to bless him? He came here, he came to me for prayer. That means he has a heart for ministry. So I always look for that to bless other people. That God has turned my heart to be having the heart of God. I thank God for that. It's not me.
Man.
I have a heart that God gives me. That when I see people, I always see potential. I hope you have that heart too.
Man.
When you have that heart, when you see somebody, this person has potential. He can do great things for God. I can raise up this person. I can train this person. I can guide this person. You have the heart to bless people. God likes that. Now I know some pastor, they're very jealous if a young preacher come out and preach with fire and energy and with conviction and the people all repented. And the pastor sit there and he said, I cannot let that man preach. If he preaches, everyone will follow him. And I have no more follower. Now if we serve like that, God doesn't like it. We have to say, I'm happy. He can do great things. I'm happy he can do better than I. That way, God is pleased with us. When God is pleased with us, he will bless us.
Amen.
He will remember us. Now, I want to share something with you. Not to glorify myself, but I just want to say, God knows your heart.
Amen.
Actually, I want to say everything I have. I want to say this again. When I experienced the Holy Spirit, I was in a weak condition. But God let me experience the Holy Spirit and totally turn my life around. I am nobody, but God changed me. All glory to God. But I want to say this. When I really found God, when I realized that what I do if it's pleasing to God, God will like it. And that I can bless people. So I really devote my heart and I take care of God so that I'm not building and tearing down the ministry. And some people started to tell me, like Manny here. One time she asked God, what do you want me to learn from Pastor Yim? And I'm honored to say, God said to her, you learn his life. That's the most important thing you learn from him. When I hear that, I say, Lord, I'm humble. I am nobody. When you use me like that and you recognize me like that, I am nobody. Can you say it together with me? I am nobody.
I am nobody.
Then God recognize me. I appreciate God. I hope you all have this heart. When you have this heart, God knows. God knows your heart. Whether your heart is after money, after recognition by people, or your heart is after blessing people, God knows. And when God knows that you have a good heart to bless people, God likes you. When God likes you, there is nothing that can stop you. When God likes you, your money will go higher and higher. But remember to stay humble. If not, you will fall higher. When you are higher up, you will really be hurt when you are higher up. I know one pastor who is very spirit-filled, who is a leader of many churches. But he sinned, and now he is in a very humble condition. He fell very low, but I still help him. I'm one person who continue to help him, and continue to encourage him, and encourage him to, you know, to first repent and go back to the ministry. And he's not starting to go back. But in the past, he's the person that has helped me a lot. And I'm sad to see him fall like this. But it brings repentance to him. And I want to help him. So I always have this heart to help people. And I hope you all have this heart. So when I see someone, I want to build up their life, build up the motivation. And from time to time, I can confront them. But when I confront them, I make sure that I will tell them, I care about you. I love you. I tell you not because I don't like you. I tell you because I like you. I love you. I care about you. I don't want these sins to control you. I don't want these emotions to control you. So I assure them. Actually, I have a habit of assuring people all the time. I always tell people, you did a good job. You did great. You're doing great. You're doing good. You love the Lord. You're very diligent. I always always tell people that, to let people know that, that what they do is recognized by God and recognized by me. And then I will tell them, ask them, what do you think your spiritual gifts are? What do you think you can do for God? And then they tell me, oh, maybe I can do evangelism. I can pray for people. And then I ask them, what are some difficulties you might have? How can you overcome those difficulties? So I counsel them. I will spend more time counseling them than helping the needy. I will help the needy too, but I will help them to handle the problems so that they can be used by God. And then sometimes I will help them again and again. And I give them opportunity to serve, to minister, so that they get a habit, they get used to serving God. And then I will give them a vision. How about going to ministry? Now right now,
I have
one way I can raise some ministers. Because now we have a training school. But this is not a regular training school, it's just an informal training program. But I train people to preach and to pray for people, to lead worship, everything, to play musical instruments, to counsel people, everything in ministry I train them. And I will work with some churches who are willing to let these people to go and serve there. And then these churches can lay hands, anoint these people to be ministers, to accept them as ministers. So I will tell them, which one of you are willing who want to serve God and go into ministry? So I open the ways, first where they are, and then open ways, new ways, that they can go to ministry. And some of them may just be ministering in the mission field, go to different places. And in the process, I always tell them, you can come to me. If you have any question, if you have any problem, if you have any needs, I will always help you. And I will see how they are growing. I will see how they are growing. If I see the potential, I will tell them, you can do great things. You can do great things. And then I will guide them. And gradually, then I build up. So this is briefly what I talk about here about raising up people for ministry or for serving in the church. But very important that I pay attention to the life quality, not just outside, not just gifts, but the life quality. For instance, there are some people who hear from the Lord very easily. They hear messages from God. And I will always tell these people, it's very important that you take care of problems in life. If not, you will hear voices from Satan. I've seen this happen again and again. People who have the prophetic gifts sometimes can hear words from Satan. But if they take care of their life and really follow God, then they will only hear God's voice. That way their life is taken care of. But it's very hard for many people to take care of all the problems in their life. And this is the next thing I'm going to talk about. Now I'm going to stop here and ask you, do you have any question about raising up people to serve God, first in the immediate level, just in where they can serve, right here, and then gradually raise them up in a mission field, and then gradually go into ministry. So step by step, build them up. And my eyes always look at these people. Who can I raise up? Who have potential? Who can do great things for God? Okay, do you have any question about this? Now, also, I want to tell you that for people who want to ask you questions about ministry, you can contact me. The reason is my concentration is in ministry for people to serve God. If you want to serve God, if you have questions, you can contact me. You can go to YouTube and look for Pastor Yip. The name is there, YIP. Not Timothy Yip, just Pastor Yip. Pastor Yip, and then you can see my video and my information there. And you can contact me with WhatsApp, with Skype, WeChat, and then I can ask you